I mean, win or lose, we're losing money, so that kind of sets the tone that this is just like playing blackjack versus the house, and we might as well just go for it. All right, well, this hand is pretty sweet. I'm gonna G probe because anytime you can turn one Rabblemaster, you just got to. It's just so aggro. Let's see what we're up against. Glistener Elf, and then Rancors. So, well, we could potentially trade with the creatures with that hand. Bushwhacker. And then Warzone's really awkward. Like, this hand's pretty awkward, actually. You know, we should just get a Bushwhacker in play because we're not going to be able to kick these guys. And we want to trade with Glistener Elf if we can. So, let's just get him out there. Bushwhackins. No sideboard, we're doing it. And we have another match where all the games should be decided in like a good 3 turns. That's really what you want. Okay, now we have an interesting play because I want the goblins from Rabblemaster. Ooh, that's interesting. It's not interesting. I want the goblins from Rabblemaster, but I also want to not block with it. Right? Double Rancor is not what I want to face. So I'm gonna go second main here. Not attack and put out the Rabblemaster. These hands have been all right. I mean, you can't run like a god all the time. I definitely would like to though. All right, well, this is the situation now. Contested war zone. Potentially gonna be handed over. Nope, looks like no attacks from the opponent. Nice. Second main. Probably an Ikraclaw here, and that guy is going to be hard to block. So maybe we just don't block at this point. That's a horrendously bad draw. I'm going to. Well, let's just send with everyone right now. We can send with the Rabblemaster if the opponent wants to double block it. Great. Okay. Handing over contested war zone feels like really bad, but it's an option. We could even use it if we wanted to. 4, 5, 6 coming in. We could make it 9. I think I would rather that we. Oh, there's no blockers. Oh, interesting. Jumps in front of the Rabblemaster is weird. It's a 1-1. Do we have a mutagenic growth coming? But then why wouldn't he block with the other one? Okay, well, it's still going to be a trade. So that's not so bad. And the opponent keeps the Glistener Elf. That seems like a mistake was made by the opponent, but we're going to feast off of that. Not like our spot is very exciting with. I mean, the amount of mana to like spells we've drawn, but that's the way the deck works. You just kind of shuffle them and then hope that you have a sweet grip. Oh my god, a live wire lash. That's gonna kill us right quick. Hopefully, it attacks and we trade. Do it. Yeah! And then he has no creatures left, maybe. He didn't just draw. Yeah, the opponent might just have no creatures left. So we could randomly luck sack him. I mean, the opponent has what left? Rancors and Wild Defiance, actually, no creatures. So if we draw a little bit of mana, like 2 mana cards, because we're going to get that back. Yeah, if we don't draw Empty the Wounds, that would be great. Alright, well, we'll see if the opponent has more monsters. They don't currently, and if they just brick, then that might give us the time we need to win. So this game has become kind of exciting, actually. Our draw is super imbalanced in terms of mana dispels. We do only play 16 lands, but we have the 4 ritual, the 8 rituals and the 4 spirit guides, bringing us to 21. No. No. Alright, well, that's gonna signal a next game for sure. Like, we almost got there. our draw is pretty horrendous. So, well, maybe the opponent will screw it up again. Just gonna pass the turn, see what happens. Oh, I should have attacked with one, because maybe he would trade, just for no reason, really. The hope at this point is that he just charges in and lets it die. Yeah, just attacks. Does not Rancor twice. Does not play well Defiant Sego. Meanwhile, narrate what I'm doing. I'm working on a braid right now. Backcombing in a lock. Just one experiment. Front of my head. One little lock. And it looks like we're going to have to go to the next game. 7-1. Didn't attack. Clicked through attacks. Alright, well, let's take the extra turn. Who are we playing against? This is pretty newbie. And, I mean, we're still losing. But, we have hope. Opponent has three cards over there. Presumably something pumps. Overgrown Battlement? Why are you in the two mans? And we draw another Empty the Warrens. Or another Siege Gang. So, yeah, like, why is the Wild Defiance not come down? How are we in this? We could attack. I didn't attack. Maybe we should have attacked with two of them. Five lands over there. Just the Wild Defiance. Seven. This is some kind of game. Just trade it off, man. Opponent is one card and it's a Wild Defiance. Well, just block one. So what's gonna go wrong? Pretty sure it's a Wild Defiance. However, Livewire Lash can get moved to the Battlement. And then Rancor can pick off some guys. Also, Contested Warzones are going over there. Yeah, the opponent can, if they figure this out, equip Livewire Lash and then nug off 2/1/1s, and we're not going to be able to get the Warzones back. So this is actually, like, horrendously bad. The Warzones are horrendously bad right now. But what can you do, man? Man, see if opponent figures this out. Well, they don't necessarily, this is actually not so bad for us, because if the Rancors get used, then they're never going to die. Opponent has a great blocker, but they're never going to be able to get those back to hand to combo them with an infect guy, so we're going to be, like, relatively safe. Did the opponent go to the face with that? Did go to the face with that. Great. So that means we can actually, yeah, this is a horrifically bad list played at Beals Malief by the opponent against an arguably really bad deck. But, I mean, it's the two mans. This is what the two mans are right now. It's like, think about it. Why would you play in the two mans when you could play in just the regular constructed cubes? You're just losing money, right? There's no upside. So you need to be really, you need to be dumb or be getting paid off something else to be playing on them. So my opponent is potentially really dumb. Don't want to say that, or he's potentially getting paid off this in some way. All right, well, next turn the Siege Gang party begins. Hopefully dodge something with Infect one more time. It's Wild Defiance, there it is, one card left. Okay. Dream of Metamorphication. Are we gonna take this game down? Siege Gang not very good against Wild Defiance, yeah. F6. Whatever creature you control, yeah, okay. So we still need to dodge Infect for, like, another turn. Dodged. Opponent's probably ranting about drawing six forests. Well, you drew 10 spells, so that's what you should expect at this point in the game. I just should I not assume the worst for my opponent? Oh, Primal Bellow to kill the siege gang. This feels bad, man. Like, this is the two man, but it feels bad because it's like, what are you playing against, bro? Like, don't know, man. This guy's paying money to play against us, so this is the meta, I suppose. Primal. This deck's clearly just miles from optimal. Alright, well, next turn we can swing 369 for 18. So, more than that, so we should have him. Don't think anything can be top decked at this point. And we can get a W on the board. Doesn't matter so much how we get it, so long as that we do get it. Okay, G probe. Play it. I don't think this is going to be the difference between life or death. Life and death. Forest. Coast is clear. Coast is clear to play another siege gang, actually. Attack. This gets blocked. 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21. So this is why. This is what happens when you find a stranger in the Alps. This is why Contested Warzone is in the deck. It's definitely potent. Alright, F6 time. Did it. Okay, well, I didn't think that we were going to win. Begin sideboarding. This matchup's probably really bad. Depending on the list and the play. How's the infect matchup? Well, I'm 100% in game so far, so I think it's really good.